problem.
Talk into a bottle.
Anyway, so I'd like to start off with a few lighthearted stories about my mother and her raising her two kids. So this is a recent story. The recent story that I heard from my beautiful grandma that told me the story. Apparently, I was not one that liked to sleep as a baby, and I guess SIDS was a big thing back then, so babies weren't allowed to sleep on their stomach. But I refused to sleep on my back, so I cried all night. And finally, my mom said, well, if he gets SIDS, he gets SIDS. I'm letting him sleep on his belly, because that's the only way that I get any sleep. So, alrighty, that's how that started out. I'm still here. I survived.
You survived.
And then my brother was very reliant on his nooner as a baby.
Oh.
And
wouldn't
put it down for nothing. So finally, my mom got tired of it and told him that the trash man took the nooner. So after a few long days of him crying about his nooner, he finally got over it. And then a few years later, she finally told him that she just put his nooner in a box and still has it to this day.
But,
but that being said, those are the only two stories that I could find where my mom was did anything negative to us. My mom's the greatest woman that I know, and she really took care of me and my brother growing up. She taught us everything we needed to know, and she does everything for us. Hence why, you know, this party might not be the greatest because it was planned by me. So I did what I could. You know, it's the first party I've ever had to plan on my own because normally I just call my mom for everything. There were many times where I was like, oh, I'll just call mom and ask her. And I was like, oh, no, I can't because it's a surprise party for her. So, but my mom's a great woman and she'll do anything for anybody. So I was glad that I could do this one small thing for her. And I want to thank everyone for coming and showing your support and love for my mom. She really is a great woman.